With tech-tober in full swing, our next set of Teardown devices are brought to us by Google. On our table, you'll see the Pixel 8 Pro and the Pixel 8, and we're looking at the Pixel 8 Pro specifically today. Quick disclaimer, we have a partnership with Google for spare parts, but we bought these phones ourselves, and Google has had no input in how we cover these teardowns. This camera visor might be an acquired taste. I personally prefer the tri-camera setup of the iPhones, but you can't deny it looks sleek. The Pixel 8 Pro does have a new feature that's a first for mainstream smartphones, a thermometer on the back. Due to FDA regulations, it's not approved to measure body temperature, but it's a pretty nifty little feature nonetheless. Combine that with a host of integrated AI tools and you've got a truly interesting Android device powered by Google's own Tensor G3 system on chip. But the question we want to answer today is, just how easy is it to repair a Pixel 8 Pro, and can you do it yourself? The front entry design means that the screen needs to come off, so on the heating mat it goes. I'll use Clampy to lift the screen and expose the adhesive. Get a pick in and cut the glue all the way around. I found this easier than going through the adhesive on the 15 Pro Max, and the Pixel 8 Pro's glue feels more forgiving too. Lifting the screen up reveals a spring bracket holding the display panel's press connector snugly in place. Popping that connector allows me to remove the screen. It's nice not to have an extra screw to worry about, but both spring and screw brackets work just fine. I can clearly see a lot of love and care has gone into the construction of the Pixel 8 Pro, but it's certainly not the compact and efficient design we see on the interior of iPhones. But that's okay, because this phone has a lot of other things going for it. Here's one example. The beautiful Super Actua panel made by Samsung can reach a peak brightness of 2400 nits, just a tad over the 2000 nits output by the iPhone 15s, which, coincidentally, also use Samsung panels. I need to get this 5G millimeter wave antenna cable out of the way, so let's fold that back. There's a good deal of carbon film sitting over the battery and extending to the camera housing. Fun fact, a common heat management trick in small devices is to use the battery and other metal components as a heatsink. That's exactly what's happening here, and this carbon film's job is to dissipate that heat through the back glass. The central frame here is fulfilling a few roles. The most apparent is that it reinforces the phone and acts as the central structure to which the mainboard is mounted. A less obvious role is that it transmits vibrations from that haptic motor at the bottom all the way up through the body of the phone. Time to remove that battery. It's worth noting here that the power connector should be one of the first things we disconnect, not halfway through the disassembly. Using the two taps provided, I spent a bit of time forcing this plastic strip through the adhesive with limited success. I can't tell if this was because I couldn't get a tight grip on the tabs or whether the glue was the problem. I ended up dousing the problem in alcohol. I'm not particularly impressed with those plastic tabs, but maybe it was just me. The battery is rated for 19.25 watt hours, which provides plenty of juice for daily use. What's more, and as is the case in most modern smartphones, you can access the battery health information in the settings, and you can even activate some clever software features that will help you extend the life of your battery. Next out is the rather puny looking 10 megapixel front-facing camera. Some press connectors and screws later, and I have the entire main camera assembly out as well. From left to right, we have the 50 megapixel main camera, the 48 megapixel ultra-wide, and the 48 megapixel 5x optical zoom telescopic camera. This housing is roughly the same size as the S23 Ultra's 10 megapixel telescopic camera, which provides a 10x optical zoom, and it's nearly twice as big as the iPhone 15 Pro Max's 12 megapixel 5x periscope camera. With the lower speaker out, I can now move on to the mainboard. There's not much holding it down at this point, but there is a coax connector on the reverse side that needs to be disconnected before the board can be freed. The top speaker is yeeted out, followed by the metal bracket holding the millimeter wave antenna. The last item on my list is that novel thermometer. It's been a while since we've seen a truly unique function in a smartphone, and I want to see how they did it. The hardware is a little anticlimactic. It's literally this tiny thermal sensor here, but this turned out to be a good excuse to look at some of the other sensors. This ST Microelectronics ambient light sensor looks particularly interesting. The sensor plays a key role in color correction. There are multiple photodiodes in here that generate electricity depending on the specific wavelength of light reaching it. The colored filters that you can see ensure that each photodiode only captures the wavelengths intended for the underlying circuitry. For the first time ever, Google has committed itself to 7 years of software and security updates for the Pixel 8 and the Pixel 8 Pro. This compares to a no-commitment average of 5 to 6 years from Apple and only 4 years from Samsung. The Pixel 8 Pro's hardware could be physically easier to access with a dual-entry design like the iPhone 15 line of devices. The battery was also a pain to deal with. Pull tabs like Apple's or Samsung's phones would be welcome, but at least the components themselves are free from software locks, something that plagues an ever-growing number of iPhone components. This means cheaper and easier repairs for the end user in the long run. The biggest win, in my opinion, is the 7-year commitment to software and security updates. This, combined with the availability of OEM spare parts, manuals, and a non-hostile approach to DIY repairs, means that Pixel owners are empowered to keep their devices running for longer.